Hey, thanks for joining us again this week. I'm so excited to have you. We're going to talk about another great group of horses coming up on our Diamond-McNabb Ranch Horse Sale. That's all coming up right here on Discovering the Horseman Within. Gonna take a ride on one true horse. I'm looking forward to seeing you at my upcoming Ranch Horse Sale. Remember, it's the first Saturday in June. So make sure you go to our Diamond-McNabb Ranch Horse website, look these horses over, or you can contact me, call 307-645-3149. Get ready to raise your hand, do your bidding, and take home the partner of a lifetime at our annual Diamond-McNabb Ranch Horse Sale. Hip number 62, Easter. This is a 2015 sorrel mare. I love this mare. She is 15 hands and 1,400 pounds. This is a big bodied mare. She's registered as DLL Double Shot. I love the way she's bred. She is by Brockleface Starlight and out of DM Holding the Spotlight by Cats Moonshine. She is bred to be absolutely a cow horse. She is a big, gentle, kind mare. She was raised on the Powderhorn by Diamond Ranches. She was started down there in one of my programs and has come right along and is a really nice, big, pretty, quiet mare. You're gonna love her. That's hip number 62, Easter. Number 63, Opie. He's a 2010 sorrel gelding, making him an 11-year-old horse that stands 14-1 hands, 1,050 pounds. Registered in the AQHA as Dale's Freckles. This is a horse we've had here for the last year. We used him up on the mountains in the Bighorns and cow camp all last summer. We've put inexperienced riders on him. We've used him in our 3-week program. To be honest, Opie's been used all over the place and done very, very well. This horse is handy sized, easy to get on, and he's a true family style horse. He's quiet in his disposition. He's gentle in his nature. You know, he's one of those horses I call the unsung heroes of the West, because every ranch has got a couple like him and nobody brags about him, but they couldn't live without him. That's hip number 63, Opie. Hip number 64, Nerf. He's registered in the AQHA as Electrified Code. What a good looking 14 hand, 975 pound sorrel gelding. He's a 2013 model. Do not let his size fool you. He has a great build and strong bone. He's very broke in the bridle and moves gracefully off your legs. Spins, slide to a stop, flying lead changes, you name it, Nerf will do it. He's an own son of Electric Code, who has a $215,000 lifetime earnings. This horse is fancy in the arena or enjoy him out on the trails. Grandma and kid approved. He is the first one to meet you at the gate for anything. He's got an extremely sweet disposition and makes him an excellent addition to any family. He's brought to us by Logan Wolf. I love the Wolf horses. They bring us great horses every year. Great family. That's hip number 64, Nerf. This is hip number 65, Sven. He's a 2014 model black gelding, registered in the American Paint Horse Association as Texas T Classic. This horse is 15'3 hands tall and 1,315 pounds, a teddy bear. He has the kindest heart. He'll take care of any rider on his back. And I've asked the girls down there at the Powderhorn over and over again, and Delaney tells me every time, he is so gentle. You can run horses on him or jump on him bareback, do a backflip off of him, do a backflip onto him. He rides out alone, he'll ride out in a group, he doesn't care where you put him. He is kind, he is personable, he is gentle, and he is fun for the whole family. That's hip number 65, Sven. This is hip number 66. He's a 2012 model sorrel gelding. We call him Serrano. and he is registered as RCA Bugs Alive Honor. This gelding stands 15 one hands and 1,155 pounds of trailblazing fun horse to ride. He is one that may initially be overlooked because he is not flashy or fancy, but he is honest and consistent every day of the year. He's seen a lot of cattle, he's good to gather on, stays quiet in the alley. He has a long strided lope and can long trot over the country or drop down to an easy, slow jog. Serrano neck reins ride soft on the bit and works well off your legs. He's good to catch, shoe, and bathe. That means your farrier and you are both going to love him, and so's your vet. He is all of that in a really neat package. Hip number 66, Serrano. Hip number 67, Cochise. This is a 2008 model gray gelding. He's 13 years old, and man, do I like this horse. He's 15 two hands and 1,280 pounds of ranch horse. You want a real deal ranch horse, this is it. You want one that'll go down the trail and not spook and booger, Cochise is there. Kurt's been riding this horse for the last year, and the night he impressed me the most. When we first started calving, he hadn't been ridden since before Christmas, so he'd probably had, 8 weeks off. It was snowing, blowing, and cold. And it was just about dark when we realized we had a heifer out in the pasture having trouble. Kurt went and caught Cochise. By the time he got to the heifer, it was pitch black. He roped her and drug her up to the barn on Cochise. That horse never did a thing wrong. He came out of the cold, hadn't been ridden in weeks, been fed well, went out, did his job, never complained. That's him every single day. Hip number 67, Cochise. Hip number 68, Little Roney. What a machine. If you are looking for a ranch horse, this 2012 model 14 three hand, 1,120 pound gelding is it. Registered in the AQHA as Smoking Jack Dunnett. I'm gonna tell you right now, this has been my horse for the last year. I have used him on the ranch. I had the guys use him up in cow camp last summer. I used him up there. If you want a ranch horse that will run the cattle and you won't miss when you go to rope. He's drugged calves, he's roped cattle in the pasture, he's worked cattle. He is a really neat ranch horse, but he is not for a beginner rider. He's gentle, he's kind, he's not gonna spook, he's not gonna buck, but he has a gas pedal. If you compare him to a car, he is a Ferrari. He doesn't have to run, but he has a gas pedal and it's there, and I want people to know that. He is a really rare individual. I love this horse, and he has all the heart you could ever ask for in one. This horse carried me through the hardest day of working cows I've had in the last 20 years, and he never faltered. At the end of the day, we got the job done in the last 10 minutes because of him and him alone, at the end of a daylight to dark long day. This is a really cool horse, but he just isn't one for beginners. Fantastic gelding, hip number 68, Little Roney. This is hip number 70, Flynn. He's a 2013 model brown gelding, stands 14 three hands and 1,165 pounds. He is a broke, smooth-moving trail horse deluxe. He wants to do right and be your friend, and he's handy size and handy broke with a great neck rein and easy speed transitions up and down. Lots of horses speed up. They don't get so willing to slow down. This horse is easy to bring back to the speed you want. He rates back. He's good to open gates on, carry a flag or a tarp, drag a log. Doesn't mind having things tied to the back of your saddle. He's been there, done it all as a ranch horse. That's the thing. When we tell people he's a ranch horse, what does that mean? It means he's unflappable and he's worked for a living. Just one of the many things it means. Megan rides him, which means he'll be soft and nice in the bridle. This is hip number 70, Flynn. Hip number 71, Shasta. VF Boss Hog is his AQHA number. 15 two hands and 1,180 pounds of pretty gray gelding. 2014 model, making him a 7-year-old horse. When you show up at the pasture gate, Shasta comes over, sticks his head in the halter, and the rest of the ride is just as easy as that. This horse has been enjoyed by many levels of rider on the ranch. He handles pressure. No matter what's going on around him, his emotions stay unflappable. He does what he's asked and he's happy about it. And all of that in a big, pretty package that you're gonna love riding. Hip number 71, Shasta.
Remember, for more complete footage on any of these horses, as well as the hip numbers that aren't here in order, go to our website and check out the YouTube footage. We talk a lot about the work that goes into these horses all year long in preparing them and the training, and that's critically important. But one of the things that I think frequently gets overlooked is the actual effort we put in during sale week to prepare them for the event of sale day.
Yeah, the work sale week, the 7 days leading up to the sale, feels like it should all be packed into a month, not into a week, because we put a lot into it with the horses, getting them ready physically in their appearance, getting them groomed and so forth, but also just getting them accustomed to the sale environment, getting them ready for that, to actually show what we've been working on all year long.
I think one of the things that makes it so successful is the practice we put in actually for the event. And I think that's one of the areas that we get in trouble as riders at home with our horses, is we actually forget to do that sometimes. We forget to practice crossing water. We forget to practice going up to mailboxes or scary things. And so for us, we know horses naturally don't like new and strange. And so we actually put some time in that sale pen with guys on the microphone and every horse going through, just to get conditioned and ready for that.
Yeah, and it does take a lot of conditioning for them to get accustomed to the sound and the noise, but then sale day we see that pay off, and they're all typically very calm and really perform their best.
One of the comments during our sale that I love to hear is when people come up and say, your horses are so well groomed.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of time goes into that, and there's a well rehearsed process to getting them looking that way.
There really is, and it's a process that starts months before the sale, but then during the sale, I think a key element that took us a while to figure out is how relaxed the bathing process needs to be.
Right, if you get them jazzed up right at the beginning of the day, going into one of the most stressful days of their lives, really, that doesn't set a good stage for the rest of the day. So we take our time, we're very calm, we're very reassuring to them, and they come out the other side sparkling.
Bathing your horse for an event is really not that different than your routine of getting ready in the morning. Just like Hannah pointed out, it's gonna be the most stressful day of their lives for us. And for you, if you're getting ready to go to a show, it might not be the most stressful day of their life, but set it up so it's pleasant. Don't wait for last minute where you're going, oh my word, I've gotta hurry up and clip my horse and I've gotta, no. We want it to be quiet, relaxed. Think of it like you're taking your horse to the spa. That's what we want it to be like. All right, well, hey, let's get back to the preview.
Okay.
Hip number 72, Thunder. Thunder is a fantastic 2015 model black and white gelding. He's 14-2 hands of 1,000 pounds, and he is a cool little horse. He is broke to ride and drive. He drives and pulls a single cart with ease. If you want a horse that'll turn heads and be well-mannered the whole time, that's him. He's been used to push and gather cows. We're not telling you he's a great cow horse, but he's been out there and done the job. He is a great horse. He is gentle, he is kind. There's nothing new you're gonna show him. He saddles up the same every time, no matter how much time he's had off. He's just the kind of individual that we are looking for, that you are looking for, to keep you and your family safe. That is hip number 72, Thunder. Hip number 73, Lefty. This is a 2011 model black gelding. He stands 15 hands and 1,100 pounds, and he has been there and done that. You want a trail horse that's seen the country, seen the obstacles, this horse has been there. We had him on the Powderhorn last summer. He's one of my horses. We had him down there for Trail Rider Universities. We had him down there for the 3-week program. Donald Archer's been riding him for me all winter. What a nice gelding. Just big, quiet, gentle, easy moving horse that has been there and done that. He's fun to play on. He's fun to trail ride with your friends all the way around. Lefty is a cool horse. That's hip number 73, Lefty. Hip number 74 is Bentley, registered in the American Paint Horse Association as Pepe Olina's Fox.
This is a 15-hand, 1,050-pound gelding that Logan Wolf is bringing us. Logan brings us such nice horses, and this one is no exception. He is very typical of what they bring me. A gorgeous buckskin and white paint gelding that is gentle, he's kind, he's sure-footed. He's been out in the country, he's been in the arena, he'll be broke to ride. He'll be the kind of horse that you're looking for, a nice, pleasant trail horse that's pretty and the kind that is the whole family. He's gonna fit in there and you're gonna love riding him. That is hip number 74, Bentley. Hip number 75, we call him Jovi. The AQHA calls him Jerry Lee Tar. This gorgeous bay gelding has been out and about and seen it all. He is 15-3 hands and 1,270 pounds of gorgeous big horse. He's a 2007 model. Myron named him Jovi because he's a rock star, and he really is. He will lay off and come back quiet and gentle. He's a big, stout horse with a sweet disposition. He's been out there and done everything that you could want to do on one. You want to take him trail riding, he's ready to go. He's seen traffic, he's been to the brandings, he's been around the cattle, he's done everything, and he is a handy son of a gun to ride around on. That is hip number 75, Jovi. Hip number 77, Chief. He's registered in the AQHA as Chief Petty Officer. He is a 14-3 hand, 1,100 pound sorrel gelding brought to us from the Houck family. He's a sharp looking gelding that they have used in all the stuff that they do as a family. They've had him out working on the ranch. They've had him trail riding. They've taken him over the obstacle courses. They've swam the river with him. They've had him in snowdrifts up to his eyeballs. This horse just does the same every time. He'll ride off alone or in a group. He's sure-footed, knows his way around the trails. He loads, he hauls, he stands gentle for the farrier, stands good for the vet. This is one of those kind of horses. You look at him, you talk to them, you ask questions, and you're gonna know he's the kind you're looking for. That's hip number 76, Chief. Hip number 77, Redman. He is a 2014 model Bay Roan gelding that stands 15 hands and 1,100 pounds. He is registered in the AQHA as Twisted Royalty. This is a good looking horse. When you look at him, he's gorgeous. And Kaysen Wolf always rides a good one. And Kaysen said, this one is gentle, gentle, gentle. There is no silly business in him. You can let him be a pretty ornament in your yard, Kaysen said, and then saddle him up a few weeks later and go for a ride out in the pasture. This horse is absolutely the kind that you give to your foreman, that you know you want to take care of. You give him to somebody who's gonna ride rarely but needs a good one when they do. This is that kind of horse. Or take him every single day because he is cowboy cool. That is hip number 77, Redman. Hip number 78, California. I love this little Palomino horse. He is 15 hands, 1,160 pounds of really neat little horse. There is no doubt about it. This is a gentle, kind individual. I would put anybody that can sit up in the saddle and hold on this horse because he's gonna take care of them. But if you want one to go do a job on, this guy will go do the job. He is absolutely dependable on the ranch, and for a little horse, he has a ton of pull. I call him a little horse. He is 15 hands and 1,165 pounds, but he's just one of those horses whose nature is so kind and gentle and sweet that you don't think of him as a big, strong horse, and he actually is a fairly good-sized horse with a lot of pull from the saddle horn, and he has been in all kinds of brandings, all kinds of country. This is a really cool horse. That is hip number 78, California. Hip number 79, Jack. This is a 2011 model Bay Gelding. He is gentle, and unassuming. I love that, unassuming, right? He's just one of those kind that, like, I call him an unsung hero. They don't demand your attention, they're just there for the job. It's easy to climb on Jack and take him for a ride. You're gonna have fun. You're not gonna have to work to catch him. You're not gonna have to work to saddle him. You're not gonna have to work to ride him. You're just gonna have fun. This is a relaxing day at the end of the week. That's what Jack is all about, making your day enjoyable. At 15 two hands and 1,200 pounds, he's big enough to carry anybody and small enough to still be easy to get onto. We know you're gonna love him. This is hip number 79, Jack.
Remember, for more complete footage on any of these horses, as well as the hip numbers that aren't here in order, go to our website and check out the YouTube footage.
At Diamond-McNabb Ranch Horse Sales, we're proud to offer a 30-day satisfaction guarantee. For more information on that guarantee, check our website.
I'm looking forward to seeing you at my upcoming ranch horse sale. Remember, it's the first Saturday in June. So make sure you go to our Diamond-McNabb Ranch Horse website, look these horses over. Or you can contact me, call 307-645-3149. Get ready to raise your hand, do your bidding, and take home the partner of a lifetime at our annual Diamond-McNabb Ranch Horse Sale. Well, you spent 3 weeks looking at horses with me, and I truly hope you found your one true horse. Remember, if you've got questions, call me right away. I want to talk to you about those horses, answer your questions. Do you want to join us in person? You can watch it online at dvauction.com. You can go to our website, diamondmcnabbranchhorses.com, for YouTube links to a lot more in-depth video on these horses. We have as much information as we can possibly push at you. So if you've got questions, give me a holler. I love to talk horses. And until next time, may God bless the trails you ride.
Gonna take a ride on one true horse.
One take, and go.
Hold on.
Two takes.
Hannah, I know that sounded kind of patronizing. Hannah, I know that you're sad. Let's get to work.
We got a lot of work to do.
Got a lot of work to do.